Again. All quadro to be here for the Golden Horseshoe Division will make presentations. First of all, to the goaltender of the month of November, Corvair number 38, Mark Sinclair. Mark played 5 games, won 4 of them, had 1 loss, and 1 shootout. Short. 6 goals against, 1.19 goals against average. The November defenseman of the month, number 55, Chad Lumman. 7 games played, 6 assists, only 12 penalty minutes, blocked 13 shots, laid on 28 hits. Number 55, Chad.
Tonight, the 19-1-1-2 first place Caledonia Corvairs face off against their closest geographical rival, the 16-6-3-2 Ancaster Avalanche. Good evening, welcome to the HCCC. I'm John Molson. Tonight's starting goaltenders for the Ancaster Avalanche, Cole Sesse. He comes into tonight's game with a record of 5 wins, 2 losses, and 2 ties on the year, a 2.00 goals against average, but his first start head-to-head against the Corvairs. These two teams, 1 win, an overtime loss, and a tie between the two of them, so all even up in the season series as Punkery takes the opening draw. Sagan on the left wing, Schaefer and Zottel back on defense to start out for Caledonia as it's dumped in deep down the far side by Owen Burnell. Joshua Pace takes his man into the boards. That's Zottel on his back, still digging away. Josh Pace, the starting right defender. Ryan Sullivan, the left defender for the Avalanche, as the shot by McCartney blocked by Sullivan. Zottel plays it up. Burnell down the right wing. He runs into Schaefer, who stands him up with two arms. The play from in behind the Caledonia net up to McCartney. Burnell, of course, the man responsible for the game winner the last time these two teams met. That was back on November the 8th here. Burnell scoring down the near side on the power play. Hoare down to the end line. And he's turned around at the far side, so he gives it to Jake Brown. Jake Brown with a quick shot poking away, and they score! Matt Hoare and Pauly's side of the net. The referee pointing to the Ancaster bench now. Don't know if that's going to count or not, but now he's going over to the timekeeper. The original shot by Jake Brown, and Hoare and Pauly standing on either side of the goaltender Sessi, and apparently now the goal not going to count. Brown plays it forward on the draw. Here's the announcement now. Pauly, the shot, and they score! No! Brown's shot looked like it went in the far side, so a disallowed goal. And the announcement right when the Jake Brown shot went through. I thought it hit the back of the net on the far side. Ratchford, the long shoot-in. You can have another look at that play, the Jake Brown play off the right wing off the quick pass on Fast Hockey, video on demand. Caledonia dropping a 4-3 decision to the Niagara Falls Canucks at the Gale Center on Friday night. Their first loss in the last six games. Johnny Curran scoring 38 seconds into overtime. The only shot of the overtime session, and Curran made it count. Daniel Volpe, Jake Brown, and Matt Hoare with the Caledonia goal. Shot by Jordan Brown down low, and Sessi with a save. It catches a piece of his right pad. Schaefer's side of the net, quick shot, the rebound, and the shot deflects off Joshua Pace and into the corner. Three paces in tonight's game. Jonathan Pace for the Corvairs, number 44. And Josh Pace and Joshua Pace, both different players. Josh Pace, an affiliated player junior. And Joshua Pace, a regular for the Avalanche, a forward. In now to take the draw is Ryan Cox. The Corvairs play it around the near board. Austin Brown back to Hoare, back to Brown now. And the Avalanche take the first penalty of the game. Pauly to Brown, down into the corner for Volpe. Volpe gets it back on the return feed under the circle, and the shot by Pauly. And Sessi hanging on down low at the far post. Pauly with the most points head-to-head between these two teams. 8 total points, 4 goals, and 4 assists in 3 games played. Faceoff from the half wall back to the point. Gave it back to Volpe on the half board. Now underneath the end line, far side, Ancaster zone, is Jake Brown. Brown to the half board. Pauly gets a stick check, plays it into the slot. Poliche on him. Brown with it, 3 Corvairs to the net. That's Volpe, Hoare, and Jake Brown on the far side. Volpe into the corner for Hoare. Hoare from the end line to Pauly, winds up, and the pass hitting the back of Pauly's stick, and Poliche able to clear to the Caledonia blue line. Pauly around the outside of Sullivan, goes to the near corner this time. Pass back for Schaefer, the long pass. Schaefer unable to bring it in and all the way back into his own zone with 28 seconds remaining on the penalty to Max Balanson. One last rush for Mitch Graham possibly, plays it to the left side, and Schaefer fires high and wide out the far corner. Graham under the underline. The turnaround, Schaefer to Zottel. Zottel plays it off the half wall. Schaefer top of the blue line, the shot, and the hard shot by Schaefer goes heavily off the left shoulder of Sessi. Schaefer pass out to Maximovic. Maximovic with 2 points in the 4-1 win on Sunday night against the Welland Junior Canadians. Caledonia with 2 games on the road following a 3-game homestand. They'll face the Falcons in a home-and-home next weekend, Friday in St. Catharines, back here Saturday. Sagan a heavy hit by Fedor Gordiev. Gordiev spending 4 games with the OHL's Hamilton Bulldogs, drawing 2 assists. Punkery a heavy hit far side. Ryan Nill back on the right defense. The hard hit on him, Ancaster able to clear. Police into the corner and Ratchford taking him heavily into the boards. Lots of good, heavy, solid, clean hitting 6 minutes in. Just the 1 Ancaster penalty. Caledonia 0-for-1 on their first power play. We're still scoreless with 13:45 remaining first period of play. Niagara Falls Canucks coming on as of late. The pass ahead to Balancin, broken up by Matt McCartney. Rymack McCartney, the shot, Brown to the net. McCartney took the shot, Rymack ahead of the play. The quick shot, the rebound, and Balancin quickly took it the other way. Shot by Noah Madison and gloved down by Mark Sinclair. Sinclair just announced winning the goaltender of the month for November. 17-3-1 on the year, a 191 goals against average. Sinclair third in the league overall in goaltending. St. Catharines' Joel Hordachuk, the number one goalie. Have to get that pronunciation right before next weekend's 2 games. Hordachuk with a very long name, I believe out of Thunder Bay, Ontario. Actually, here's Rymack to the net. Couple weeks ago, actually looked up the pronunciation online. And I think that's the right one. We will have that cleared up for you next weekend. St. Catharines, their first visit into Caledonia, close to the Christmas break. Caledonia, 2 games, home games remaining till the break, and the shot high stick side by Graham, and Sessie places it to the corner. Gordiev on his man. And it was Hoare down heavily at the end line. Ancaster clearing the other way. Caledonia out shooting Ancaster the last time these teams met, 37-23. Drop pass to Pauly and he scores! So the Jake Brown goal with 2 men to the net called off. And Pauly this time, making no mistake, goes top shelf near side over the right shoulder of Sessie. 11:49 to go in the period. Corey Pauly, the league's number 2 leading scorer. Good drop pass from the end line, shot by Hoare, partially blocked by Balancin. So it was Brown on the far corner with the presence of mind for the long drop pass. Shot saved by Sinclair to the net, Madison. The initial shot by Balancin off the left side. Brown has his stick lifted. Paliche, Hughes the shot wide. Paliche to the far corner, two steps off the hot board, his shot. Sinclair directed it aside. Jonathan Pace, and he tips it back to Sinclair. And Sinclair stops the puck with 10:51 remaining in the period. We'll take a break. You're watching Corvair Hockey on Fast Hockey. In the draw, Maximovich placed it back behind the Corvair net to Zottel. Maximovich to Volpe, Fitzmaurice on his left wing. Fitzmaurice to the right side, the shot, and Sessi with a big save underneath the right arm. Fitzmaurice with the pass to Maximovich. Maximovich can't take the draw cleanly against Ryan Cox. They'll redo the draw from the right circle out to the left-hand side of Sessi. Pace, the pass in behind the back of Volpe. Cox pins him up against the wall. Joshua Pace plays it to the line, but Jordan Brown, the interception, plays it deep in behind the Ancaster net. Back out to center, Pace plays it in. Sinclair rings it around the near sideboard. Maximovich on the pass from Volpe, short back pass to Fitzmaurice. And Fitzmaurice, his momentum carries him in behind the Avalanche net. Caledonia 8 points ahead of the St. Catharines Falcons going into next weekend's set of games, and the puck out of play on the far side. Caledonia 22 wins, a loss, a tie, and two overtime losses for 47 points. And St. Catharines 19 wins, four losses, and a tie for 38 points. Play to the far side, Schaefer unable to keep it in. Zottel off the board. Sagan leaves it for Maximovich, or McCartney, excuse me, shot by McCartney down low, and the right pad saved by Sessi. Another shot by Zottel, this time off the opposite pad of Sessi. Top of the blue line, shot into traffic, and Zach Lawrence gets a piece of that on the Schaefer shot. Heavy hit on the near half wall. Sagan on Madison, now off to the end of the Ancaster bench. Pass not handled by Lawrence. Caledonia tried to keep it in at the line. Couldn't get a handle on the disc, so the bouncing puck played in, and Caledonia off on a change. Icing, 8:31 to go in the period. Niagara Falls hot as of late. A tie in Ancaster last night. Niagara Falls out shooting Ancaster 48-37. Ben Hughes with the game's opening goal for Ancaster at 17:12 of the first on the power play. Kevin Boyd scoring shorthanded for Niagara Falls. Ancaster, the shots in favor of Ancaster in the OT. Shot by Paliche, the quick shot, the feed from Gordieve, and they score. So Ancaster on their second power play. Paliche connects with 8:19 remaining in the period, and the Avalanche tie this one up at one. So Pauly at 11:48, the wrist shot, high top corner near side over Sessi. And now Police with 8:19 left. Quick shot by Brown. Jordan Brown, the shot, the rebound. Rymack on the corner. Pace, Graham the interception, and it's taken away by Josh Pace. Burnell hit hard on the board by Schaefer, played back to Jordan Brown on the back pass from Graham. Rymack to the far side. Sessi out to the corner at the goal line. The pass out to the high right circle. Pace unable to do anything with it for Caledonia, and he goes off on a change. Shot hard to the net. Cole Nagy, and the deflection just wide. Schaefer back with Burr on him. Dustin Burr giving the hit to Schaefer, forcing a turnover. The shot by Burr got the pass out off the far wall. And the shot by Owen Norton. And Sinclair hangs on with 6:41 remaining in the period. Caledonia, or Niagara Falls rather, with the win over Caledonia Friday and the tie last night in Ancaster, moved themselves into the number four spot, 1 point ahead of the Welland Junior Canadians. Welland with a good start to the year, but starting to slip back a bit now. St. Catharines was back in the Golden Horseshoe Conference for a good portion of the year, just based on the fact that they played far fewer games than anybody else. The Falcons now with two games in hand on Caledonia, so a possible 4-point swing there, but Caledonia shot by Brown. It hits the stick of Norton and tails off into the far corner. Caledonia still with an 8-point lead going into next weekend. The shot gloved down by Sinclair. St. Catharines will be in action Tuesday night against the Niagara Falls Canucks. A 7 p.m. start at the Jack Gatecliff Arena in St. Catharines. The draw won by Ancaster. Norton played it down the near side. Pauly swings over. The pass to Bauman. The shot, Bauman. Brown, a attempted deflection. Nice play by Jake Brown there, covered by Balanson. Got the deflection regardless. Shot by Bauman. The defenseman of the month. Bauman, as we heard in the pregame announcement, over 20 hits for the month of November. Bauman at 6'3", 228 pounds. Shot wide by Ratchford, picked up off the glass. Volpe. Madison play in the neutral zone, ahead to Nagy on the pass from Lawrence. Caledonia, I'd say, with the edge in shots so far. Police tying the game with the power play goal. 11:41 of period number one. Shot by Volpe, rebound Fitzmaurice. Maximovich on the far side. It was Fitzmaurice with a shot. Gordy back to center by himself as the Avalanche make a change. Sagan with speed down the right wing, Sullivan on his back. Played to Punkery. Punkery shuffles it to the sideboard, and the shot wide on the deflection by Ratchford. Hughes ties his man up, so he plays it back to Gordiev. And Ancaster able to clear at the near side of their line. Manella, Sagan, and Josh Pace now back defensively for Ancaster. Ahead to Hughes. Hughes lets it go. Brown to the far side for Pace. Punkery, the pass in behind his forehand side. And Sullivan picks it up for the Avalanche. Ahead to Hughes. Hughes at the red line, the long pass in. Burr in behind the net, tied up by Jordan Brown. Grabbed by Graham, and he's quickly tripped up by Burr. So Dustin Burr will sit down for 2 minutes, and the Corvairs will go to their second power play on the slash in between the legs. So after the Michael Pollice goal, at 11:41, the Corvairs will look to retake the lead, 3:18 remaining in the period. 7 games in the GOJHL tonight. 3 already completed this afternoon. Check www.gojhl.ca. And a reminder, this game brought to you by ARC Pro HD, servicing all your broadcasting needs for the past 15 years as the Caledonia Power Play continues for another minute and 25. Pass to Volpe. ARC Pro HD as it's cleared out by the Avalanche. 519-755-7409. Or info at arcprohd.com. You can also watch on Fast Hockey, $22.99 a month, as Matt Hoare tries to break through. Angled toward the left side down through the slot. Hoare now in behind the goal line. Took it from the end line. Hoare shifted in behind the Ancaster net, tried to catch Sessi asleep at the far corner. Hoare trying to find a blind spot. A loose puck ended up at the far side of the net. Hoare couldn't quite control it on the wrap around, out around the far corner. Caledonia unable to get a shot away, but a nice idea there nonetheless by Matt Hoare. Graham to the far end line. Centering pass, Fitzmaurice, and they score! Maximovich with the great pass from the end line. Spotted Mitchell Fitzmaurice. Fitzmaurice just enough room off the back-checking defenseman to slide it in on the forehand. Fitzmaurice getting the forehand blade free and shoveling it in the near side with under 2 minutes to go. Heavy hit on the far side by Punkery. Sagan knocks his man down, and another hard hit by Pollice, shot off the glass by Punkery. McCartney in behind the net, Sagan on nil. Caledonia shorthanded 18 times in the last two games, but allowing just one power play goal coming in tonight before the power play marker by Police. Good hitting in the far corner by Sagan. So Caledonia, both sides with a lot of hard hits. Caledonia just the allowing just the two power plays. Turnaround shot by Paulie, Hoare there as well. Under a minute to go, Brown losing possession to Ben Hughes. Bauman plays it ahead, puck loose underneath the Ancaster bench. Bauman to the far side, Ratchford to Pauly. Hoare one on three, but got in behind the two forwards, Gordiev and Owen Burnell. Hoare going one on one with the defender Balancing and got a shot away, but it hit the back of a stick and went out of play. 18.6 seconds remaining in the period. Jake Brown on the draw. Hoare will stay in behind on the left wing at the top of the circle on the draw, but it was Cox winning the draw, dropping to Balancing, and now playing it over the far side is the left winger. That was Pazabon, the buzzer going. Norton taking a shot long into the far corner. Pauly with 11:48 remaining in the period, then Police tying it up for Ancaster. 4-3, Kitchener an 11 game winning streak coming into today. 24-0 and an overtime loss in their last 25 games. So the Winter Hawks with an upset at Kinsman Arena, and the shot off the right shoulder of Sinclair, the shot by Pace. Schaefer looking to go down the right wing. Brown takes it instead to Pauly. Hoare now with it in the corner. He's tied up, and the freed up puck comes to Owen Burnell. Burnell drops the Balancing. Balancing hammers high and off the glass. Schaefer now to Zottel around the right side of the Caledonia net. Hoare, Pauly behind him. Brown on the backhand, tries to get back to Pauly in the slot. Shot by Jordan Brown. Pauly's side of the net to the end line. Broken up by Norton. Police down the left wing on the quick pass from Ben Hughes. And Sinclair cutting the angle perfectly. The high shot, Sinclair coming across to his right-hand side. And the save on Police, the first goal scorer for the Avalanche on the pass ahead by Hughes. Police and Hughes stay out. Gordiev in behind them. Manella and Ryan Nill on the points. And in to take the draw for Caledonia is Daniel Volpe. Puck skidded off to the right-hand side. Volpe picked it up on the second opportunity. Went deep in behind the Ancaster net. Shot by Ratchford. Nice downward deflection by Mitchell Fitzmaurice. Hammered into the boards by Gordiev. Maximovic able to get up on the hard hit by Gordiev. Thought he initially hit Fitzmaurice, but it was Maximovic. See if Gordiev gets more than 2 minutes for the hit from behind. Caledonia now to their third power play. In the draw, Cox and Volpe comes to the right side. Pauly on the point to Brown. Brown gets it back, played around the outside. Pauly, the shot goes wide. Hoare at the end line. Brown to the far side wall. Pauly winds up, and it deflects off Burnell. Burnell in a lot of pain. The hard shot off the right side of the point. And Burnell having a lot of trouble getting back to the bench. He took a shot on the right side. Sinclair out, the long play out by Ancaster to kill the first 45 seconds of the Caledonia power play. Caledonia with 40 power play goals on the year and 100. Excuse me, lost my voice and couldn't regain control. Shot by Brown on the feed right wing from Hoare. Caledonia 166 opportunities on the power play coming into tonight. Two in the first period before the third, 3 minutes into the second period. Unsure whether or not the Fitzmaurice goal was a power play goal. Under two to go on in the first when he scored that one. Seemed to have a lot of Wi-Fi problems in this building. Caledonia always the last to report a score. And often it's a period or so behind. Keep checking www.gojhl.ca. Fitzmaurice to Graham on the corner. Fitzmaurice gives back to Graham a second time. Feed out, intercepted by Gordiev, leaving the penalty box for Ancaster. So Ancaster at 84.43% on the kill tonight, or excuse me, on the season coming into tonight, kills off the Gordiev penalty. And Gordiev now off to the right wing on the draw. Cole Nagy loses possession on the far wall to Maximovich. Gordiev to Burr, and it's dumped in by Dustin Burr. Sinclair out to play it to Zottel. Zottel up to Maximovich, now leaving the zone. And Fitzmaurice leveling Burr. Almost sandwiched there in between Fitzmaurice and Maximovich. 4 minutes gone in the second. The whistle going with exactly 15:39 to go. 2-1 Corvairs, no scoring so far in the second. And now the Avalanche go to their first power play of the period. Elmira 5-0 over the Listowel Cyclones at home. 9:35 remaining in the second. Fort Erie and Welland tied at 2. 6:47 remaining in period number 2. And 1-0 St. Thomas over Strathroy. Gordiev down the wing for Paliche. Paliche and Gordiev back and forth, pass under the end line. Long return feed from Hughes, and Gordiev has to go back to neutral ice to pick it up. Gordiev turned around by McCartney. McCartney now forcing his man deep. McCartney trying to lift the stick of Gordiev. Gordiev just a 99, so McCartney trying to take advantage of his lack of experience. But Gordiev, one of the youngest players in the league, already with OHL experience with the Hamilton Bulldogs. Played 4 games up there in the month of September. The pass across, Hughes to the net. Matt Manella went down to the left wing. Haven't seen much of Manella, so a fresh set of legs for Ancaster as Manella down the left wing. Volpe to the net, tries to make a move around Balanson. It was the Maximovich pass that sprung Volpe free. And now Norton back quickly down the right wing for Ancaster. Nagy to the right wing boards, the swing around for Cox. And Volpe takes his man heavily into the board. Norton down hard and spun around down a second time is Owen Norton. Ryan Cox to Burnell, shot by Burnell, and the block by Bauman, the November Defenseman of the Month. Maximovich plays it up underneath the Ancaster bench. Cox brings it back across the far side for the Avalanche. And Bauman now to the neutral zone. Volpe back for Fitzmaurice. Volpe the shot, and it goes high up over top the net and off the glass. Play ahead to Hughes over the left wing for Manella. The inbound feed for Ratchford. Ratchford off the board. And play comes to a stop, 12:43 remaining in the period. This game brought to you by Arc Pro HD Incorporated. Arc Pro HD is a high definition video production company specializing in new media delivery, such as web streaming, preparing video for use online and for use with mobile devices. With over 15 years of experience in all areas of video production, Arc Pro HD can just help you to discuss how you would like to reach your target audience. Call them today, 519-755-7409 or info@arcprohd. A reminder, you can watch this game live on the arcprohd.com website or on fasthockey.com. Play comes back to the neutral zone as Ancaster offside on the far corner. Jake Brown with Hoare on the right wing. Owen Burnell on opposite Hoare. Cox in the draw, he wins it, slides it back to Norton. Norton brings it to center after the short pass from Balanson. Zottel plays it around the near wall, balancing the shot. Caledonia tried a long clear out from behind their own net. Balancing trying to capitalize with a quick shot right on goal. Sinclair cutting the angle at the top of his crease by moving off to his right stick side. Knocked down by Balanson. Balanson tries again from the left side of the line. Rymack able to clear out. Rymack didn't play in the last home game. St. Catharines 8 points back at Caledonia with 39 points heading into the important home and home next weekend. Schaefer plays it to the Ancaster blue line. Rymack shot by Schaefer. Schaefer's original clear in. Bounce back to the neutral zone, and then Rymack quickly down the right wing. Jordan Brown to the neutral zone for Austin Brown. Schaefer, Nagy on him. Schaefer moves around Nagy, plays it ahead, two steps over center to Austin Brown. Long clear in by Schaefer. He goes on a change. Hoare and his man tied up. That's Nagy. Josh Pace ahead to Cole Nagy. Lawrence shifting over to the right wing, and it's Nagy taking the shot. Goes wide. Sagan picks it up. McCartney back past the Hoare. McCartney to the net. And McCartney tripped up, I believe, by Josh Pace. A hook. McCartney hard to the net. Caledonia went 3-on-2. Sagan the pass ahead to Hoare. Hoare out on the left wing for the draw. Pauly shifts back to the top of the blue line. Volpe out the far side looking for Brown. Hoare to Volpe. Ryan Nell cuts him off. Gets enough of the disc to play it to Jake Brown. Austin Brown beside the right circle. Volpe takes the shot. It hits Nell's stick, deflects into the corner. Nagy heavily on Pauly, and Nagy able to clear down the far side deep as a result of the heavy hit on the far corner. Pauly, Volpe in behind the net. Pauly with Sullivan. Volpe gets it, plays it to the left side. Austin Brown across to Jake Brown, back to Austin Brown. Down the right wing wall. Austin Brown to the far side, and the shot by Volpe, wide and hard off the board. Brown centering pass, looking for Hoare. Hits the defender Sullivan into the corner. Hoare, 29 seconds left on the Caledonia power play. Austin Brown to Hoare. Hoare, the shot, the attempted deflection by Jake Brown, and now Jake Brown caught on the two-on-one shot by Burnell. And Cox to the net as well. Burnell and Cox went straight to the net on the two-on-one. Jake Brown caught on the deflection. Certainly not Jake Brown's fault. He got the scoring opportunity he was looking for. Just resulted in the quick two-on-one for Ancaster. Shot by Joshua Pace and gloved down by Sinclair with 8:02 remaining in the period. Ancaster 2 points back of the St. Catharines Falcons. So they can actually move themselves back into a tie with St. Catharines by virtue of games in hand and more wins. St. Catharines will still stay in the number two spot. Shot by Schaefer, deflected wide. Picked up by Graham. Fitzmaurice the shot. May have caught a piece of the bottom left pad of Sessi. Graham around Hughes. Graham, a good move around Ben Hughes, angled to the left there. Ben Hughes, Ancaster's leading scorer with 35 points. Hughes tied for 23rd going into tonight in league scoring. Play in behind the Caledonia net. No play for Hughes as he lets it go. Graham Berg grabs it away from him. The shot by Police. The rebound. Shot by Hughes. Fluttering shot. The Ben Hughes shot nearly found its way in. Another shot by Hughes. Hit the side of the net. And Hughes now the shot from in behind the end line. And Sinclair has to cover up at the near corner. Great shift by Hughes. First the arc shot, then a shot hit the side of the net. Then he tried to make a play from in behind the net. Ancaster second in the conference to Caledonia in goals for. But Hughes just 23 in the league coming into tonight in league scoring. trying to add to his totals on that shift. No scoring in the second, still 2-1 Caledonia. Played to the far side, cross ice feed. Bauman to Rymack. Rymack, a heavy hit on Sullivan. Everyone picking up the hitting, including Rymack. Bauman taking out Pazabon. Went low. See if Bauman draws a penalty for taking the legs out. Could be a kneeing call. The Caledonia box now open. Bauman went low, and it's Bauman that's going to sit down for a slash. Bauman with the slash down low on the Ancaster player's legs, and the faceoff win by Hughes, nil to the far side. Gordy to the corner looking for Police, and it's tipped out nicely by Volpe. Sesse plays it to the left wing board, but not out. Gordy in behind his own net. 5:38 to go in the period. Hughes the pass to Police. Too far for him and picked up and cleared by Schaefer. Sesse to Gordiev. Gordiev with the long pass to Manella. And Zottel picks it up, throws a long pass to the blue line. It hits the boards and deflects in behind the Ancaster net. McCartney to Schaefer. The play down the near board. Nil knocked it down with the left glove, and he has it now and plays it far side. Gordiev up to Burnell. Burnell with Hughes heading to the net. Looking for a centering pass. Cole Nagy parked out front. And the shot, Sinclair tipping it into the corner. Balance into the far side. Balancing gets it back. Played over to Hughes, left circle. Turn around by Burnell. And Nagy falling in behind the net. And Schaefer picks it up and clears the length of the ice. 4:17 remaining in the period. 15 seconds remaining on the slash to Bauman. Burnell through the neutral zone. Rochford on him. Burnell back to the half board, backing up a couple steps, and Balanson taking the shot. Rochford around the board. Bauman to the red line, tips it ahead. Maximovich, the play off the corner. Maximovich, another chance. Couldn't get a shot away on either opportunity as he was tied up by Ryan Cox. Shot by Nagy tails out the far side. Long shift by Cole Nagy, and he finally goes off. Joshua Pace in behind his own net. Plays it to Nil. Less hitting in the second, but still good solid hits nonetheless. Both teams doing a good job of staying out of the box, approximately three penalties aside for both teams. Again, the Wi-Fi at the HCCC tonight behind a little bit. Keep checking www.gojhl.ca. The shot by Hughes deflecting wide, and Sinclair's net knocked off the far mooring, so a stoppage in play with 2:50 to go. 5 games in the NHL today. Chicago 3-1 over the Jets. Hurricanes over the Arizona Coyotes 5-4. New York Rangers over the Senators 2-0 after a period. The Devils 2-0 over the Panthers. And the Ducks and Penguins, an 8 o'clock start. They were yet to get underway at last check. Shot by Brown Ceci the save. Ceci actually fourth, tied for fourth in goaltending. Played, has 9 games played, so just enough time in net to qualify amongst the league leaders. Matt Callis, the regular Ancaster goalie, in the number 23 spot with a 3.36 goals against average. Hoare tied for fourth in league scoring. Pauly, the second leading scorer, drops for Schaefer. The long pass ahead to Nagy. Burnell to the net, the shot by Police, and it hit Schaefer and went into the corner. Schaefer with Burnell up against the board. Nagy grabs the freed up puck, and the shot by Josh Pace goes wide of the net. Pazabon played a pass around the boards. He goes to the far corner now looking to knock it in, but it's Burnell and Pazabon tied up with Zottel and McCartney in behind Mark Sinclair, the Caledonia netminder. Shot by Pace. Josh Pace, the affiliated player, looking to impress in limited action with a hard shot down low off the right corner. Moved all the way into the circle from the right side of the blue line. Under a minute to go now, second period. No scoring in the second. The last goal of the game, the Mitchell Fitzmaurice goal from Maximovich, with under 2 to go. Played around the boards. Ben Hughes able to keep it in. Had that good shift earlier and knocked down by Bauman. Hughes with a good shift around the midpoint of the period, looking to end the frame the same way. Shot by Graham, another shot. Mitch Graham breaking through the check, and the shot off the right shoulder of Ceci. Puck out of play, 10.3 seconds remaining in the period. Caledonia with the home-and-home series next weekend against St. Catharines. St. Catharines in action Tuesday night at home against Niagara Falls. Ancaster also with 2 games next weekend. Friday in Niagara Falls, a 7:30 start at the Gale Center. The horn goes, and it's 2-1 Caledonia following 2 periods. Ancaster at home to Thorold Saturday, December the 12th. Back for period number 3, Ancaster and Caledonia. 1-1 and 1, these two teams. Maximovich played the opening draw to the far side. Gordiev cleared it in. Pass to the wing for Volpe. Volpe cuts to the slot. Good move to from the left wing by Daniel Volpe. Maximovich to the sideboard, the turnaround, Volpe another shot. Well, actually no shot on the move to the slot, so Volpe with the first shot of the third period. We're 45 seconds in, no scoring in the second. an evenly played second period. I'd say Caledonia with the shots lead. Again, backhand shot by Brown seconds ago. He cuts to the net. Pauly with it now on the right wing boards. And the shot by Pauly sails wide on the near corner. Bauman to Hoare. Hoare in behind the net. The turnaround Pauly. Ratchford chips the puck away from Matt Minella. CeCe looking off to his right-hand side. A mispronunciation on the CeCe name earlier. Sorry about that. Saw some of his relatives at the beginning of the period saying hello. And now Ratchford, the long pass. Norton breaks it up. Bird drops it back for balancing the defender on the other side. Played ahead to Nagy. Sinclair out of the net. Drops for Bauman. Graham to center. Two on three with Nagy back for Ancaster. Graham carries him into the far board. Jonathan Pace back for Caledonia. Jordan Brown up to the blue line. Check the stat line on Matt Rymack in the intermission. Hasn't played the last three games. Listed as playing 22 games for Caledonia, but Rymack seldomly used. Was a call-up from the Hagersville Hawks last year. Unsure if he's spent any time there this year, but he's seen limited action with the Corvairs this season. Down on the far side, Lucas Pozzebon, a injury in behind the play as the Caledonia trainer, Ted Belaz, goes to have a look at him now. On the out-of-town scoreboard, you heard the finals. Guelph over the Brampton Bombers 3-2. So Guelph moving to 38 points on the year, within 6 points of the second-place Stratford Cullitons. Chatham 6-2 over Lambton Shores. Lambton Shores dropping to 5-21-2 on the year. And Pozzebon escorted to the end of the Ancaster bench. He'll go straight to the room by the looks of things. Chatham with their 17th win, tying the St. Thomas Stars for second in the Western Conference. Kitchener upset. Now with two losses on the year, the Dutchmen remain at 55 points on the year. The shots and Claire gloving it down. A hit to the head, Ancaster now on a 5-on-4. McCartney for a hit to the head, and Graham serving the penalty. Balancing the shot, the rebound, Nagy on the doorstep. And Zottel and the right defender wisely back for Caledonia. That's Schaefer. Hard shot by Balancing. Somehow Sinclair able to see it through traffic. Cambridge with their eighth win on the season on that 4-3 victory over the Dutchmen. Caledonia with three games in hand on Kitchener. Trying to do the math, seeing how the Corvairs could move ahead of the Dutchmen for first overall. Caledonia with a win tonight would get to 49 points. And with the three games in hand, with three wins, but it'll be difficult with the home and home next weekend against St. Catharines. Put themselves in the position to put themselves. Gordy with a pass over to the wing, shot by Cox, and the deflected shot goes out of play. 43 seconds remaining on the penalty being served by Mitch Graham. Caledonia could move themselves into a virtual tie for first overall. So again, the big upset this afternoon. The eighth place Winter Hawks over the first place Dutchmen. Cambridge still 3 points back of the seventh place Brantford 99ers. They play Thursday night at home against the Brampton Bombers. Just ahead of them, Brantford 3 points behind them. Attempted clear, coughed up. Paliche could do nothing with it. Hoare back one on two. Waits for men to get on side. Shot by Brown. Goes in behind the Ancaster net. Hughes to center down the right wing. A nice heavy hip check. Back to Hughes was Jake Brown. Norton up to center. Tipped in by Owen Burnell. Jordan Brown to Nick Zottel. Zottel to Pauly. Brown there as well. Pace grabs possession, shot by Joshua Pace, the rebound, and they score. The short rebound, and Owen Burnell tucks it in. The original shot, Burnell left free. Sinclair almost getting over to his left side, but it's Owen Burnell with the tying goal. Burnell, the killer in the last game between these two teams here, scoring at 3:27 of the first overtime period. Pauly, Norton to the far side. Joshua Pace creating that play with the original shot down the over top the left circle. Sinclair allowing a very short rebound, but Burnell free at the side of the net, tucks it just under his left side, shot by Pauly. Interesting side note, Adam Kowalik of the Dutchmen actually moving ahead of Pauly in the scoring race this week. Kowalik with 29 goals, 39 assists for 65 points. One ahead of Pauly going into tonight. Now Pauly had tonight's first goal, shot from the right side. Don't know what Kowalik did on the leaderboard this afternoon in the 4-3 loss. Again, check www.gojhl.ca. Rymack to the net and his shot wired wide. Schaefer picks it up from the far side of the blue line, plays it in behind the Ancaster net. Sullivan down the far wall. Zach Lawrence, stick lifted by Graham, creates an opportunity. Graham drops it back to Austin Brown, and the hard shot by Austin Brown wide of the net. Elmira 6-2 over the Listowel Cyclones. The shot gloved down by CeCe. Listowel dropping to now in fourth place, 28 points. We're all the way up to second early on in the year. but now starting to drop back a bit. Listowel just two games over 500 now with a loss. Hard shot by Jordan Brown. CeCe caught a piece of it on the far corner. Gordieve around the wall, nil on the far side under the end line. Plays it to Police, bounces over center. Hughes with a lost stick, tries to kick it ahead. Two plays on the far side by Hughes. Playing it in between his feet, the left ahead of the right, and good work with the feet by Hughes despite having no stick. Welland 4-3 over Fort Erie, trying to bring themselves back to the number four spot. Now held by Niagara Falls after the impressive weekend over both these two teams. The tie coming last night, the 1-1 tie, balancing the shot down low. Ben Hughes with the only goal last night at Morgan Firestone Arena. 17-12 of the first period. The Hughes goal on the power play. Norton plays it to the corner. Schaefer a hard hit on Owen Burnell. Schaefer plays it inside the blue line. Max balancing with it now. Zottel the backhander up off the top of the board. And CeCe leaves it for balancing back defending. Maximovic on the forecheck. Sagan comes in. Cox to the Caledonia blue line on the pass up to Nagy. And Norton rings it around the wall. Far side, Ratchford plays a backhand for Caledonia, and just over the line, Caledonia clearing into the neutral zone. Austin Brown the turnaround, the long feed, CeCe, Gordy back for Ancaster. Pace in the box for Caledonia. Ancaster now looking to break a 2-2 tie. Burnell with the tying goal at 5:22 from Joshua Pace, not to be confused with Josh Pace, the number three defender. And it's picked up, long shot, shuffled aside, and Gordieve back for a second time for Ancaster. Pass across to Nil. Police dropping to Gordieve and the long dump in from center. Hughes on the backhand, Zottel out to meet him. Jordan Brown to the far corner. Pace and Hoare slaps at the feet of Nil, created a loose puck. Nil distracted enough to lose possession. Hoare played it out front to Brown. Pauly from the across the left circle. Pauly speeds up, two quick steps to his left, trying to dig it away from Matt Minella. Pauly down the right wing, cuts into the center, drops back over the right, shot by Jake Brown, and it's whistled wide and over top the net. Police, Hughes on his right, and Police, the puck bounces just enough. Centering pass, shot by Burr, and Sinclair out to meet him. And what a spectacular save at the top of the crease by Sinclair. We'll take a break with under 10 to go. It's 2-2 Ancaster and Caledonia. Maximovic on the draw. Cole Nagy moves it ahead. Faceoff out of play on the far side. Caledonia back to full strength. Rochford and Bauman, the defensive pairing for Caledonia. Volpe on the left, Maximovic, and Fitzmaurice grabbing it on the draw, switches wings, the shot wide. CeCe caught a piece and deflected it into the corner. The shot going wide, but CeCe moved over to direct it to the corner. The shot by Rochford at the end line. Volpe, a man on his back. Bauman plays it ahead. Ryan Sullivan plays it up the far board, cut off by Maximovic, and the shot. Bauman under the end line, centering pass for Fitzmaurice. Sullivan down, and CeCe covering up at the top of the crease. In the NHL, five games today. Penguins over the Ducks at last check. 3:20 to go in the first period. New Jersey 3-2 over the Panthers. That after two periods at last check. Rangers over the Senators 2-1 at the second intermission. Hurricanes over the Coyotes by one. Graham the shot. It sneaks through CeCe's legs and they score! Mitch Graham breaks free just enough to stick it in between the legs of CeCe, and the Caledonia Corvairs get their lead back on a misplay. Ancaster zone, the Ancaster defense coughs it up close to the goal line. I believe it's going to be Graham unassisted. Under 9 to go in the third period now. Caledonia now looking to hang on to a lead. Big hit by Zottl coming across the neutral zone on Hughes. Zottl, a high hit on Hughes. High on the shoulder, 11:37, the time of the goal. Matt Rimac, you say Rimac, I say Rimac. I was told by Jeff Hoppe, the assistant coach, that it's Rimac. I've been asking around and people are saying Rimac, so when I get a final word on that, I'll let you know. Hughes from the side of the net, nil to the corner. Shot by Gordiev, and it's kicked aside by Sinclair. Shot, Ancaster on the power play. Interference, a pretty high hit on Zottl. Took a couple of steps. Surprised they didn't call a hit to the head. I'm not saying it was a hit to the head. More high on the left shoulder of Hughes, but the league very intolerant on high hits. Zottl to sit for 2 minutes for interference. Now under a minute to go. The shot by Gordiev tails into the corner. Bauman tied up with Minella. Hughes with it now, centering pass, and nicely picked off by the captain, Sagan. He goes off in favor of a fresh Jake Brown. Pauly drops back at the red line, as does Jonathan Pace. Balanson plays it to the wing for Norton. Ahead to Cox, Brown on him, Brown got a piece of it. That was Jordan Brown. Burnell to Balanson. Back to Burnell to the end line. Cutting to the net. Balanson. Balanson stick caught the back of a Corvair player, but it may be the Corvair for diving on Balanson that's going. A slash. No, it is balancing with the stick work down under the right circle, going to the box with 6 seconds remaining on the penalty to Zottel. Balancing not happy with it. The infraction in behind the, in actually in behind his back, but you can't be careless with the stick. Fitzmaurice played it to the line. Volpe knocked it down. Burnell back the other way. Zottel back on for Caledonia. Plays it to the wing for Hoare. Back to Zottel, the shot. And it hits traffic. I believe Sullivan deflected to the corner. Fitzmaurice with it now. Drops to Jordan Brown. Far side, the shot over top the right circle. Volpe in behind the net. Owen Norton on him. Jordan Brown dropping to Hoare, gives back to Jordan Brown. Brown has a look off to the left to Hoare. The shot, Fitzmaurice with his right hand in the air, but Cece getting enough on it to get the glove down at the angled to the right side of his crease and make the save. Fitzmaurice thought he had a goal. Hoare on the forehand from the left side of the blue line. And now the second power play unit out for Caledonia. Pauly with Brown and Hoare stays on the right wing. Back to Brown, across to Zottel. Cox on him, plays it in behind the net. Hoare to Pauly, Gordieve on his back. Pauly the shot. Brown to the top of the blue line. Austin Brown takes a step, and the shot deflects out the far corner, and Ryan Nill clearing the rest of the way. So Caledonia will continue on the power play for another 34 seconds. Ancaster, if they can kill the penalty, will have about 4 minutes left in regulation to tie the game. Heavy shot by Hoare. Brown the pass from the right side. Hoare on the forehand. Off the board out the far corner. Jake Brown around the board. Zottel gave to Brown. A long pass from the corner, the shot, the rebound. Jake Brown tries to dig it out. Back to Zottel, the shot, and it hits the glass and deflects around the near side. Hoare, the pass out, looking for Pauly. So Graham, the go-ahead goal, the garbage goal, the Graham right in front of the net, taking out the garbage, so to speak. The Ancaster defense coughing the puck up at the 11:37 mark, and Graham sneaking it between Cece's legs. 3:30 to go now. The home and home for Caledonia next weekend in Pelham, Tuesday, December the 15th. Back at home to St. Catharines Saturday, December the 19th. So back-to-back home games after not seeing the Falcons here at the HCCC this year. Turnaround by Brown, then the Christmas break. Caledonia and Fort Erie to start the year Saturday, January the 2nd. And these two teams play back here in Caledonia Sunday, January the 3rd, 7:30 p.m. here in Caledonia. Ancaster in Niagara Falls Friday. Play Thorold and Fort Erie at home December the 12th and Thursday, December the 17th, respectively. A reminder, see us live on ARC Pro HD or fasthockey.com. Pace the shot, and a heavy save by Sinclair off the right shoulder stick side. Icing as Norton watches it pass him, and the puck passes Volpe as well. And then three straight games between Welland and Ancaster. Saturday, December 19th for the Avalanche at home in Welland, the 20th. And those teams start the year Saturday, January the 2nd in Ancaster for a 7:30 game. Under three to go, two goals in the third period. Burnell tied the game on the short rebound at the 5:22 mark. The save by Sinclair off the draw, balancing the shot. So seconds later, they'll have another faceoff from the same spot. Hughes and Maximovic on the draw, but Ancaster will take a timeout. Pauly to open the scoring from Jake Brown and Todd Rochford, 11:48 of the first. That was the wicked hard wrist shot, top corner by Pauly. Just checking my stat line here, the 21st goal of the year by Pauly. And then Paliche, his 13th goal to tie it at one. There was 11:48 remaining on the clock when Pauly scored. So 9 minutes and 12 seconds in, I believe. Then Paliche at 11:41. Fitzmaurice ended the period. Maximovic and Graham assisting, under 2 minutes to go in the period. Shot, it hits the outside of the post. No scoring in the second. Burnell in the third to tie the game at the 5:22 mark. And then Graham, the loose puck from Rymack at 11:37. Puck deflects up and out. Bauman and Cox come together. The puck deflects high and into the Caledonia bench. 3-2 Caledonia with 2:04 remaining. Faceoff in the neutral zone. McCartney and Hughes. Hughes wins it, drops for balancing. Burnell wraps it around the board, all the way around from the far side. Hoare the empty net, and he scores! Matt Hoare with his 20th goal. Hoare with his 35th point. Going over the scoring now. Don't believe Hoare had another point tonight. May move into sole possession of fourth place in scoring with the goal. I have that here. Broomhead in the number three spot with 53 points. Hoare number four. So Hoare ties Hayden Broomhead for third because the Culletons not in action today. Bauman with his 10th assist. Net still empty for Ancaster. Sullivan plays to the board for Pace. Turnover at center. Jordan Brown tries a shot. Dumped in by Ryan Cox up to center. Volpe on the left wing, the shot. It deflects off nil and wide of the empty net. Hughes centering pass for Fitzmaurice. Shot and they score! Jordan Brown, the shot from the neutral zone. Caledonia with two empty net goals. Jordan Brown with 36.4 seconds to go, but they're not going to count it. See if we can get an official explanation there. Wide open shot from the neutral zone. Here's another chance for Fitzmaurice to the net, and he scores. There's the 5-2 goal with Burnell chasing. Fitzmaurice crashing into the net. Again, www.gojhl.ca to have another look at the official score sheet. Fitzmaurice with his second goal. 20.1 seconds remaining. So the Jordan Brown goal at 36.4 called off. So Caledonia with their Sinclair with his first assist on the year. And the Corvairs players celebrate the 5-2 victory over the Ancaster Avalanche. Their second win on the year, so Caledonia moves to two wins, a tie, and an overtime loss on the year versus Ancaster. Ancaster moving to 1-1. 1-1, I believe, but don't quote me on that. The Corvairs saluting the fans. Because both teams were a win, an overtime loss, and a tie. So I believe that drops Ancaster to one win, a loss, an overtime loss, and a tie. And Caledonia moves to